women's health care, a 10-to-1 match. We left the money on the table. We think we've done a responsible job, and we want to be sent back to make sure we're good stewards of your money. Please vote for Joe and I on November 3rd. Thank you.
Thank you. And the final speaker is going to be Anthony Coppola.
Thank you. I want to thank everyone for giving me the opportunity and the chance to clear the air and speak to you. I can't thank you enough, and it's been very humbling for me. You know, as I said, I come from an immigrant family. You know, I want to encourage everyone to please read about me. You'll see. You'll see the true me, the real me. I definitely want you to keep on reading and listening and watch, and you'll see who I really am. And I know my family's proud of me. I'm proud of me. I know you will be proud of me also, the more you read and find out who the real Anthony Coppola is. And, you know, look, I put myself through junior college, college, and grad school all on my own, no help from the government, no help from my parents, no help from the banks. I get it, you know, and I'm a business owner. I think it'd be nice, wouldn't it be nice, to have more business owners down in Trenton who understand how to balance a budget, who understand how to, you know, work the spreadsheet. That's, I think, what we're lacking. We need more women and men down there who are business owners like myself and know how to actually create jobs. And, you know, I, as a councilman in River Edge, you know, I also understand that on the government side. I work very hard with my constituents on both ends of the aisle, Republican and Democrat, so I know how to work well, you know, with both parties to keep a balanced budget, to work across the aisle. It's important. We all have our issues and problems, not a Democrat problem, Republican problem. These are issues for all of us, so I plan to work for all of us. And, you know, I also wanted to just say, too, something that's close to my heart would be if I ever, you know, to get the chance to go down to Trenton, there'd be jail reform, prison reform. We have way too many young men sitting in jail with no criminal record. They got pinched for smoking pot 3 times and looking at 5 to 10, you know, years in the clink. So we really need to, I would be shining a light on that. I come from a family of police officers, and that would also help the people that are working in the jails, the overcrowding in jails. This is the land of the free. We have way too many young men incarcerated for a silly reason. Again, if you're a murderer, you're a rapist, you're a pedophile, you're a drug dealer, you go to jail. You use drugs, you go to therapy. Thank you.
Thank you. And now I think we want to thank all the judges.